Hi everyone, to our next tutorial on the application called REVIT with Small and Simply House Part 1. Each project we start with making grids. Every grid can be numbered from 1 to 100 and in the alphabetical way from A to Z. Newly inserted grids start numbering from the previous one. After making a copy of one of the grid, next one will have another number. Each number we can edit. The escape button turns off the active tool. Previous active tool was making grids. Now we will make walls. Options about walls are on the grid panel. We choose height and the level where the top of the wall will be placed. We can use also location line. In every new project, the best idea is to use core center line. We can choose from the menu a different of walls we have prepared in our project template. Choose one and make a rectangle on the grids we made before. You can see the lockers in the walls. The lockers helps us to align the wall to grid. Choose modify tool and try to move grid. You can see that wall is going with the grid. It's because we use the lock tool after making walls before. These two grids are aligned with the walls. Another two ones are not. If you move the grid, we can see that wall is not moving with the grid. Try to choose modify panel, then align tool. Try to click to the grid. Use the menu above the drawing. Choose center of core. Select grid and then select the core of the wall. Then use locker to align the grid to the wall. Make the same with another one. After this, try with every wall if it's working. If it's not, try to move to the modify panel and align grids to the walls. Let's create a ceiling under our walls. Ceiling and beams with insertions under the story where we are currently standing. Go to the level 1 and use floor, structural floor. Use pick walls from the menu. If you use pick the wall, we can select the wall. And boundary of the new floor will be inside or outside our walls. We can choose arrows, and arrows are helping us to moving the boundary of the floor. Remember about structure of our building. Always we make the boundary of the floor outside the core of the walls. Delete annotation of the floor. Trying to find 3D menu, view 3D, and then try to go to 3D view where we can see what we modeled before. If you cannot see 3D view in the panel, you can try customize your panel. We can see 4 walls and 1 floor. In the 3D menu, we can see View Cube. View Cube helping us making our view from the different distance. Try to go to Panel View, then choose Tiles. If you choose Tiles, then you have 2 windows. It's the best idea to work on the 2 windows. You can freely select and edit every item, or in the 3D view, or in the floor view. In the floor plans, we can see walls, but it's very difficult to select floor. Try to make a roof in the 3D view. We will use roof. We will use roof tool. Then try to go to our menu, boundary line, and choose peak wall. If you choose peak wall tool, it will make automatically aligned boundary to walls. And if you move walls, then you will move roof. It's the same with floor. Also, when you make a roof, you can use overhang. First, you need to try the units, because if I tried 80, it was too low. You need to make 800. After this, I'm using 3D model and also freely using a floor plan. If you use shift and scroll, you can rotate your 3D view. If you try to change grids, the walls are changing. Walls are changing, and then after walls, floors and roof is changing. If it's not, you used not peak wall tool, or the walls are not aligned to grid. Go to elevation, to the east elevation from the project browser list. You can see the grids and levels. Try to change the level and see how the building behaves. Every time we can change level. In the start of the project or in the finish of the project. And everything is aligned. Aligning helping us making very fast decisions and solve the problems with height. We can move through filling out keyboard or making it by a hand. If you try to change the name in the same one that level one has, it will make a error. And you can see that error is not allowing us to change the levels in the same name. After changing the name of level 0, you can see another pop-up. Would you like to rename corresponding views? It's asking us if you want to change the project browser name. Because we can change the level name, but the name of the project browser name is not changing. You can try. Try to change level 1 only in the elevation. You can see that level 2 is the same as before. You need to change it by hand. Try a new tool. Select level 0, then go to panel modify, then open copy, click 1, and then in another way, another place. You can change the number by keyboard. After this, you can make foundations. Use the floor plans, but you cannot see your new level in the foundation, in the floor plans. You need to go to view panel, then to plan views, and then try to make a new floor plan from the level you did before. Close the floor 0 plan. Make level -1 visible. Try to use view tiles option to make two windows beside. Open some elevation. And you can see that you cannot see in -1 grids. It's because on the elevations grids are not intersecting level minus one. If the grids are intersecting, they are visible in the view. And then we can see A and B grids on the minus one level. This is because of the view range. View range you can check in the properties panel. If you click view range, edit, you can see a cut plane. If the grids cross the cut plane, they are showing in the level minus one. Please check our next videos. This is part one, and you can download a template from the project in the comments.
You can meet us in Krakow, Poland.